So continuing on with our wiring diagrams, we're at the stage now where we're doing the intermediate switching. So this is where we've got three or more switches controlling a lighting point. As long as you have a two-way switch, the switch in the middle here is the intermediate switch. You can have as many intermediate switches as you like, as long as at each end there is a two-way switch. So we're using three positions for this drawing, but you could have an infinite number depending on how many intermediate switches you put in circuit. Key question that is sometimes at multi-choice exams, how many intermediate switches can you have? So a limited number of intermediate switches in order to control a lighting point, as long as each end has a two-way switch. Again, this is a wiring diagram, and as we said before, the connections within the ceiling rows. So if we look here within the ceiling rows itself, with our block of three for neutral, block of three for line, block of two for switching line, and our earth terminal for our CPCs, exactly the same here in the back of the lamp holder, block of three neutral, block of three for line, block of two for switching line, and a earth terminal for the CPCs. This here will help you wire in those accessories, as will the switches. We looked at in a previous video, the two-way switch, common L1 and L2, or terminals to that suit. Sometimes you've got L1, L2 and L3, but you've got a common or one terminal on its own and two other terminals. Okay, so that's there. So exactly the same. This diagram here will help you connect up a two-way switch. And now we introduce the intermediate switch. It's one gang, so there's only one switch on it. When we turn it over, there are four terminals making this an intermediate switch. They can be labeled L1, L2, L1, L2. They can be labeled, in this case, L1 and L1, L2 and L2. And I have seen them labeled L1, L2, L3 and L4. It's important from the point of view only that a cable coming in the top goes in here and here. So the brown and grey of a cable coming in goes in the top, and a cable brown and grey goes out the bottom, and not across the side. So we won't bring a cable in. So this cable, when it comes in, we use the brown and grey either in the top two or the bottom two, and the one going out goes in either the top two or the bottom two, and we'll see that in the drawing, and definitely not across the side. So the brown and grey of these wouldn't be connected across here. That's a common mistake when wiring up intermediate switches, that we make the connections in here incorrectly. We'll do the drawing correctly, and if you follow the two together, you should be able to wire up the intermediate switch with ease. Take it back one stage to start with. We looked at our two-way switching in our previous video, and it's exactly the same wiring diagram. Apart from this section here, we'll introduce another switch. The intermediate switch goes in here. So again, if you've got two-way wiring circuit, you can make an easy adjustment by adding an intermediate switch in. And that's probably what you'll end up doing in the workshop. So exactly the same. So a good recap for us. Fuse, neutral link, earth terminal for CPC. Probably won't help you with the connections in the consumer unit, but again, they're there. These connections and these ones in the switches will be helping you wire up in the electrical workshop. We're going to bring a cable from the consumer unit to a light fitting using 1mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable. So we've got a line, our neutral and a circuit protective conductor. We'll put those in first. Remember, you will be using a rule. I'm not, I'm going to do it freehand, and I'm also doing it upside down. So the line coming in, as always, is going to go into the center block of three, the looping terminal. So it's going to go into this center block of three, the loop-in terminal, and it doesn't matter which of those holes we choose. Again, try and make it as easy as you can for the drawing. So I'm going to use this one here, out of the loop, and it's going to join up to the line conductor between here and here. Again, you'll need a rule. So our line conductor comes into our loop-in terminal. Let's take next our neutral. Again, the block of three here, any of those three can be used for neutral connections. So as we look here, any of those three can be used as our neutral connections. It doesn't matter which one we go in. It's a brass block with three holes in it. So let's come out of this one here and bring our neutral connection round as best we can, straight as Gaz can do it. There you go. So that's our neutral connection in. And then our CPC comes out of our consumer unit, out of the earth terminal, and is going to come into this terminal here. We look here, there's two on this one for our CPCs to go in, and on this make, there's just the one CPC terminal. Remember, we've talked about it previously, all the accessories in the workshop we're going to be working with are plastic, including the boxes. The CPC is there in case we change it for an exposed conductive part. So let's bring the CPC in. like so. And again, some of my learners do like to just put a slight strike of yellow down there. Still only one cable, it's not two cables now because I'm doing two lines. And then it becomes my CPC. So what we've done there is we've brought in from the consumer unit permanent line, neutral and CPC. Line, neutral and CPC. We've connected it into the looping terminal for the line, the neutral terminal for our blue neutral conductor and the earth terminal for our CPC. And we're going to bring the cable down again as if we were going to a one-way switch or a two-way switch in our previous drawings. Exactly the same. This cable comes down from the light to the switch. We're going to use twin and CPC cables. I mentioned it in a previous video, but somebody commented we could use twin brown here. And we do often at Tresham use twin brown. So rather than using blue, brown and CPC, we use brown, brown and CPC. I've kept these drawings using twin and CPC because you see it a lot in industry, the twin and CPC going down to a switch and identifying the blue conductor differently. And we'll talk about that again. And also other colleges tend to use it as well. So I'm just trying to push our learners. Our learners will probably use twin brown. They'll be able to adapt. The rest of the world is probably using twin and CPC and identifying this one. So again, it gives my learners that mental push to think, hang on, is this a neutral or is it a switching line on the drawing? What am I using in the workshop, etc.? But this could be twin brown and CPC. So again, this cable is going to come down from the ceiling rows to the first switch, and it will be a two-way switch. Let's start first of all by doing CPC. So CPC comes down, connected into effectively the plastic box we've got in the workshop. So that'll be the plastic back box it'll go into. If for some reason at your college you're screwing down metal boxes in order to hold your switch fronts on, you can note there is a CPC terminal in the back and the CPC would go into there because obviously this is metal. Tresham College, we're using plastic back boxes. There is a CPC terminal in the back of the plastic one just to hold the connection in place. But of course, plastic doesn't need to be earthed. The CPC is there in case it's ever changed. Maybe we change the switch from metal switch, etc. So it brings the CPC down. See if I can line these up a little bit better than I did in my previous drawing. So one of these is going to be the switching line and one of these is going to be the permanent line. So if I take this one here, so the blue one, we're going to come out of either L1 or L2 and connect it into my switching line connection. My permanent line is going to come down and it's going to go in either L1 or L2, like so. Remembering that this is not a neutral, so this cable here coming down to the switch is not a neutral, it's a switching line conductor and needs to be identified by inserting a piece of brown sleeving over the blue when you terminate the ends. And to show that, we're going to use a brown marker pen to show the sleeving on it. So that's to identify the sleeving. It's important you put that on. That is not a neutral, it's a switching line. And it goes in L1 or L2. So again, it doesn't matter which one of the two terminals. As long as it doesn't go in common, it can go in either of the other two terminals. It doesn't matter. So that brings that cable, our 1mm square twin and CPC, down to our first switch. And we're just going to link them together using 3/4 and CPC cables. So these 3/4 and CPC will go from the two-way switch to the intermediate, and a separate cable from the intermediate to the other two-way switch. So that's what we're going to do next. A little bit difference here because this symbol here doesn't actually appear on the intermediate switch. So we've just got the four terminals, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then there's this sort of block here of drawn in, which obviously doesn't appear on there. That is simulating, depending on your college, a connector block. This could be a connector block, or it could be, it depends how you want to say it, Wago or Wago, a Wago connector, or it could be a through crimp or splice. So that picture here can be any of those three. It's just to join the cables between. It doesn't, no connections for that conductor, they just pass through, and we'll look at that in a second. So we've got these colours now, brown, black, grey and our CPC. Let's put our CPC in first, make it nice and simple. So our 3/4 CPC goes between here. And again, if we want to strike a little bit of yellow onto it, we can. So our CPC comes through. We're now left with brown, black and grey. I like the brown, which is the permanent line here, to be the permanent line coming down. So that brown one comes from here. And remember what I said about the switch. The cable coming in will take either, doesn't matter which, the top two or the bottom two. So this brown coming in from the 3/4 has gone in the top one. Doesn't matter which one of the two it goes into. And then we've got the other connection here, which will be the grey. So I take my grey connection, I come out of here, and I go into there of my intermediate switch, leaving just my black cable. My black cable is going to go from the common here, and it's going to go through the connector. So maybe we're using a Wago connector. So it's not going to be connected into the actual switch itself. It's not going to be in any of these terminals. It's going to be separate and floating around in the back of the box. But because these are switching line conductors, the black and the gray, we need to identify them accordingly. Again, to represent the brown sleeving here, we're going to put a little brown mark against the black one. Brown mark against the black one here. Brown mark against the grey one, and brown mark against the grey one there. So they're all identified as switching line conductors. So that's the three core. From this two-way switch, we came out of common with the black. Doesn't matter which way around, we did L1 and L2. We had the grey and the brown cables coming out with the corresponding brown and blue from our twin and CPC cable, which was from our light down. CPCs are connected together, and that three core has been inserted. We repeat the process now coming down. Maybe I'll start with the black this time. So my black is going to come out of my connection, floating around in the back of the switch, and it's going to go into my common terminal. And then we've got our grey. I'm going to pair them off, so effectively the bottom grey and brown come out in the same positions as the top one, but it wouldn't matter. So it wouldn't have mattered if this one was brown and this one was grey, but we all like to draw it and connect them like that. So this will be grey and this will be brown. So we bring out our grey conductor from our three core. And then we bring out our brown conductor from our intermediate switch down to our two-way switch, like so. Again, we need to identify the switching line conductors, put our brown sleevings on in each of those positions, like so. So now we've got a three-core cable. We just need to make the CPC connection to complete it. Bring down our green and yellow cable, and again, just strike a little bit of yellow against it. So from the intermediate switch, we've come down now with another three core to our next two way. So within our intermediate switch, we've got a brown and grey in the top from one of the cables. The bottom, we've got a brown and grey from the other cable coming out the bottom. And we've got this cable, which is our black one, just being connected in the back of the actual box floating around. It's no connector, there's only four in here. The Wago connector will pass the common loop through. Our CPCs are connected as usual, and there are connections. So that becomes our two-way and intermediate switching. Remembering we said we can have as many intermediate switches as we like. So if I inserted another one here, I'll just break the brown and the gray and join through the black cable, exactly what I've done here, as many times as I like before I get to the final two-way switch or the first two-way switch. So it goes two-way switch, as many intermediate switches as you like, followed by a two-way switch in order to control the light and circuit. That's what we're going to end up doing in the workshop, consumer unit, light and three switches with the cable connections as shown here in this drawing, and this drawing will help you make those connections. But you might be lucky enough to extend your circuit. So again, you might find that this is in area number one, and then we carry on to into second area or further down our wooden board, and we repeat maybe a one-way, a two-way or a two-way and intermediate circuit again. In order to carry on exactly the same as we did before, we take out our brown and we go into the next room. We can take out our blue neutral and go effectively along our wooden board into the next room, and we can take our CPC out and we continue the process on again. So what we're doing there is taking a permanent line, goes into loop of the next ceiling rows, a neutral into the ceiling rows neutral terminal, and a CPC into the earth terminal of our next ceiling rows. So we come into our next ceiling rows here, and we just repeat whatever process we need again. So we can do a one-way, two-way, or an intermediate light circuit. So this just needs completing now with the cable, which is the flex. Okay, so if we bring out our brown onto our lamp and our blue onto our lamp, if the circuit is in the on position, depending on our switching sequence, our lamp will illuminate. One thing to bear in mind on your intermediate switch, it's either in this position where it passes straight through, and you can see the diagonal lines, it actually switches on the diagonal. So it goes from the grey one will switch across to this brown one at the same time. This brown one switches across with this grey one when you operate the switch. So when you're operating, it's either straight through or across the diagonal. That's something we'll cover when we actually physically wired it up into the classroom or in the workshop. We'll talk about this interconnection in order to find the position whether we're on or off. You can work it through yourself, moving the blades of the switches I did in a previous video, but just remember this one goes across both diagonals or straight through from its switching position. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.